Hi, Tech Rob here again. We're going to continue the 3D printer build, the E-axis assembly. So let's have a look. So here we got the parts laid out, and tried to get the parts divided up into the different parts of the instruction. If you remember from the previous video that I will link up the first part. There's actually 66 steps in total. And, yeah. So anyway, now the instruction was to at first gather the parts for the fan, for the extruder cooling, and the was to open up this wire and take like one. Disc, open that up and then unwind it till we get a little bit more free wire. And then the other instruction was to we need to actually take the mini cam. It's to actually position. Oh, come on, light. Black on that. So to put the motor wire and tuck it behind here, like that, so it actually goes in the corner. No, it's not easy to. Not easy to film. Ah, there. You get the idea. So it's out of the way. Anyway, the idea is that it's tucked away and out of the way of the fan. Extruder the cooling fan in place. Just like that. I'm supposed to like put the wire like that. Supposed to go. Just go like this. And the fan needs to sit on there. The wire needs to be tucked away. In the duct, the most easiest thing to do, maybe. I think I got it. What I would like to do is to actually show it. Oh, it all fell out. That's when I was going to show it. Fiddled it in there, and then I can, unshow it. Okay, that wasn't the easiest thing to get. Okay, how do we explain it? Okay, you have the fan, and you have the fan lead, and it actually comes out of the fan there. Notice how which way around the fan is, and then it comes out, and you need to at the same time you push the fan into the corner. You need to you need to push the cable into this duct here, and then you need to get it to stay in this duct behind here, and then you need to bring it around the corner and out here so it actually comes out like that. It wasn't that easy. I struggled with that a little bit. Because this is very like springy wire. so it wants to spring out. But anyway, now one has that in place. And they have actually the same, they have it in the instructions. So let's swap to this one. And then you can see they try and describe the same thing. Like how to put the fan and push it into the corner, and how to make sure that you've got the cable going around and then out. And then there's to be three screws, not four, very important. And we need to orientate this as in the instructions. We actually put those, so this screw, there is no screw there. So we need those two. We can take that piece of paper away. Can move that over there. Doesn't get in the way. And this is self-tapping. So there's no nut behind there. So I suggest don't tighten them up fully before they've all been started. So it's going into a printed part. Okay, why is this one not wanting to go in? Whoa! Something wrong in the alignment. Uh-huh, no. Yep. Well, I need to make sure the wire's not pinched, but I don't think it is. So let's see if I can show it up here. So just make sure that there's no clearance between the fan and the base, indicating the wire has caught some print. Check the other side also. See if I can show it. Don't think that's the case. And don't tighten these too much, because then might end up breaking the fan. Reasonably tight. So I hope I've done this correctly. See if I can get it to focus. There. Good. So that's what it looks like. There. So something like that. So, I hope that's okay. And the fan. Check that the fan still. That it still rotates. So it's not jammed up. Okay. So that's done. So, what have we got here? It's the extruder idler. Step 27. And I've already gathered the parts, and I've already gathered these parts. It's actually quite tricky. So those are the parts you need. There's the bearings and the shaft and the nut, and then the Bontech without the hole for the grub screw. I think we take these and we just assemble it. So that's just to put the spring on. Oh, just actually do like that. Okay, step 28, bearing assembly. Insert both bearings. That's in there. Then we need to have a look at this. And we need to put the nut in there. Might actually have to use a screw to put it in. If I can push it in. Let's see if it wants to double check in the picture to see if it's actually gonna go in. It should actually end up in deeper than what I have it now. Well, according to the picture, it should go in deeper, but that's really stuck at that one, and it will not go in. I think I'm just kind of for safety reasons. No, wait, no, it just jumps out. What? Come on. What's wrong with the screw hole? Ah! What is stopping it? Oh, yeah. Or the nut hole, to be more precise. So I just used a 10mm, borrowed a 10mm screw, and now it screwed it in. So now it's actually, let's see if I can get a good pitch. Yeah, now you can see, now it's gone in there where it's supposed to. Have to be a bit careful with these parts because they are only plastic. So one gets a bit uneasy when one has to apply more force. Okay, so that needs to be that way around, and that needs to go in. Oh, there, theoretically speaking. So hard. And then this won't tack. Won't tack. Needs to go in there like that. And then somehow I need to get that axle through without breaking anything. Okay. Okay, pushing it against the table seemed to do the trick. Doesn't seem to come right the way through, though. How can I make sure? Still a ways down the hole on this side, when it's even on this side, but the bear, it does turn, so I think my understanding of how this is going to be used, and that's actually pretty much a non-issue. Okay. Okay, so now we need to recheck the alignment. And that's... Oh, how can I show that? So the filament needs to go through the top, past that cogwheel, and into the PTFE tube. There. The alignment needs to be good. And I've actually, to tell you the truth, I've actually lost my plastic bit, so I have to I'll go and get another one. Okay, so I ended up realigning it just a little tiny bit. I don't know if you can just see it. So I pushed the filament through the top, and then I gave it a bit of assistance to go through the PTFE, into the PTFE tube, which is there. You can just see the white part. Let's see if I can get it focused up here instead. Yeah, there you can see that tube there coming through, and then it comes through, and then I'm just going to tighten it where it is now, very carefully. You don't want to over tighten. So, hope that's okay. You can pull the filament out. And now we can put this in place. And then we'll go around like that. Like that. Okay, I just need to get this screwed in. Boy, gave up. Yep, minicam gave up. So probably the battery. So that's the power back. Okay, now we have that, and that was step 31, and we need to make sure that this still moves freely when the screw is tightened. Show here also. So that's the screw there. So don't tighten it so much that this can't move anymore. So this needs to actually move free. Okay. And then we need to insert. Okay. Ah, okay, that's the other. I get it. One has to come to the other side. Okay, that makes more sense. And this needs to go through there. Oops. Actually hold the... Oh! Actually hold it shut. And put that there. And try and screw it in until it... It's getting too big. Yeah, so the dust disappears under the surface. And then it screws through to the other side. And then it's there. So, okay, that's like that. And more paper goes. Right, so now we're going to do step 32, 33. Print fan support. So that is there. So. So, that's the parts. Okay, I might need to pull the nut through because it needs to be inserted. Okay, I'll film that down. I don't know if you can see it. Ah, there we go. It needs to go into that hole. Using the screw pulling technique. There you can see the knot at the bottom now. And I'll just put the screw through so I can pull it. Oops. Tools flying away. And then need to check. Needs to go. Screw in we have to use that ball. The screwdriver. Okay, I think I'll have to use edge pointing down or right down to the extruder. So maybe I'll actually have to show it on the big camera. Oh, focus. Yeah, thank you. Like that. It does look a bit weird, but. Well, that's the way the instruction says to put it. And then we have step 35, fan shroud. And those are these parts. Okay, this is going to be a bit of a vent. So a little bit tricky to get in there. And just check that the hole is lined up. If I can create another color. Let's see. Ah! Keep the hands away. So just to make sure you can see through it. Lined up properly. There. Through the lens. Okay, now we have that, and then that should be put onto where we didn't have the screw for the fan. somewhat in there. No, that's the definitely wrong. Aha, that way. Okay, now I get it. It's not easy to look at those pictures sometimes. That third screw is a bit tight to go through. Doesn't look good. No, I think the screw's not going in properly. So this is the issue I'm having. It doesn't look correct. Oh, okay. Back in a second. So, I was struggling, and then the piece of plastic fell off. And I actually don't know from where. I actually don't think it's critical, because I couldn't see anything broken anywhere. But it could have been the plastic bit that was like a leftover of a support structure for the printing that was blocking it. So anyway, I did actually get this in place. So now it's actually where it's now at all angle. So like that. And then this is the screw. And that's the fan side screw that goes through and then screws into the side of the shroud where it had the nut. So that's okay now. No idea where this came from. And it doesn't look bad. Other than I have a theory that it might have been a part of a support structure. I'll just keep it now. But I have looked at it many, looked it over, and I can't see that it's anything critical, at least related to the form of either the fan shroud or anything else. And the fan shroud is not broken. I mean, it's get it to focus. So it's basically how it should, within tolerances of 3D printed parts, of course. This, of course, with 3D printing with plastic material, that's what would drive most machinists nuts, because the tolerances you're talking about are a lot far away from what machinists are used to handling. Okay, what are we doing now? Print fan assembly. Okay, so now we need to get that in place. Step 38. Say the picture is not really super informative, or maybe it's just the angle that this thing is gonna sit at is so weird. try and understand how this thing is going to sit. Ah, okay. So I wasn't actually in doing it oneself. It actually makes more sense than looking at the picture they tried to take. Okay, so let's see. Okay, M320. So that's one of them. And let's just put this over there. Ouch! What the hell? Sorry for. Ow! Okay, that's the still exposed sensor. Ow! Hope I can get a hole in my finger. So, let's try and screw this carefully in. Don't crush it. Like it says in the manual. Nope, can't do that. And then it's this one. One more that should have. Actually, okay, there's a nut to put it. You need to put a nut there, and then the screw goes from that side. Okay, don't want the nut falling into the extruder. Okay, I think I'll just get a long screw and pull it through, as one usually does. So, now it's in place. Two screws. There you go, one can sit on that one also. Okay, so let's see, is there some wire routing that needs to be done? This channel here. There. I'll have to open this up a bit. Alright, let's pull a little bit extra. Supposed to stretch it. Okay, it's just not going to stay in there anymore. Bit of slack on that. So, it's gonna drop out of there. That's pretty much guaranteed. But let's just leave it like that now. A little bit of slack on it. Next phase. It's the pin dive sensor. It's this one. want it. Probably gonna be adjusted later, I would think. Instead of pin the sensor in the hole, the exact position doesn't matter. Okay, it's gonna be adjusted later. So, trying to push it into place. Cable to loop in a special way. So you can push it up and down. So something like that. Yeah, with the fan cable going behind it. So. What a chaos of wires. No, that was the same when I built my other printer, so yeah, can't be avoided. So that was 39 and 40. Now we have step 41. FS cover parts preparation. And FS cover filament sensor cover, I think they would call it. One of those papers again. The electronics of the sensor that was sticking me before. So that looks like that. It's absolutely awful taking video of black ports against black ports. No, I can't even stand up in that orientation. What a... and that's supposed to work after we've actually been fiddling with all those wires in multiple different directions all day long. We'll see. I suppose one should think positive. Okay, so we need to... 43, extruder parts preparation. Zip ties, and then we're going to have to Whoa! Should be a channel, and that I had real big problems with when I was building my other printer because they were blocked. Something like that. Just feed it through. And the same for the other side. Well, those channels seem to be pretty free, so that's nice. Okay, so that's done. Now we need to get the printer over. Okay, let's see how we can get this fixed. So now, in theory, we should put the whole assembly, extruder assembly, on this x-axis. Oh, the wires just seem to drop out of the way, that's good. Or no, they don't touch. Untangle these. Let's see now. Oh, it's just in the picture. It seems to just be pushing all the cables away to the side. Okay, let's try that tactic for now. Okay, and then just blocking with my hand. Well, that should be the alignment. This is not good. I'm gonna have to block it with my hand, otherwise I can't hold it. Or maybe I can actually do it this way. Okay, not easy. There. Oh, had to block it with my hand. And then the zip tie end, or the bulky part, should end up on top. According to the picture here. Set the zip ties, lower the x-axis, so I did that, this one. Place the extruder on the bearings on the top. Couple must fit perfectly, make sure the x-axis carriage is facing towards you. Together with the shorter extrusions. Whatever that means, because right now I think it's actually correct according to the pitch. We will adjust the lower bearing later on. Tighten and cut the zip ties. Okay, so we've got lots of zip ties, so I actually don't have to worry about this. I've actually disassembled printers. So I'll just put new zip ties in, so I'm dealing. done. Okay, now some cable routings. Okay, so we need to make sure these cables actually do come, which was kind of expected. Like that. And then we're going to do the same. Ah, just to flop the cables over from the other side. Except for the extruder cables that will not be coming this way. Presumably. Okay. Wonder how I could show that. There. To move the mini cam. See. Oh, I haven't got enough cable for the minicam. Anyway, now. So, now you can see how the cables are really come over here. So, that's that. Oy. Camera's flopping all over the place. Oh, okay, that was part two, and I'm gonna call it a video. If you found this interesting, consider subscribing, because we're gonna do more. You know, send this as information to other people if they're struggling to put this thing together. And, you know, hit the bell icon, because then you get notified when the next episode comes out. So, I'll see you in the next one.